Hello, this is your daily dose of news from On Manorama. I'm your host, Renju Raj, and these are the major news stories of Wednesday, October 18, 2023. US President Joe Biden lands in Israel, says Gaza hospital blast that killed at least 500 was caused by militants. X, formerly known as Twitter, starts charging new users for basic features in New Zealand and Philippines. Delhi court convicts all accused in 2008 Malayali journalist Soumya Vishwanathan's murder case. Congress leader Rahul Gandhi accuses Adani group of fleecing people through inflated calling boards, says will prop if elected to power. India hikes government employee inflation adjusted allowance by 4% ahead of festival season. Let's get into the details. US President Joe Biden arrived in Israel on Wednesday, pledging solidarity in its war against Hamas and backing its account that a blast that killed huge numbers of Palestinians at a Gaza hospital had been caused by militants. The incident wrecked White House plans for Biden's emergency diplomatic mission to the Middle East, with Arab leaders calling off their planned summit with the US president. Palestinian officials blamed an Israeli airstrike for the blast, which it said had killed as many as 500 people. Israel said the blast was caused by a failed rocket launch by the Palestinian Islamic Jihad militant group, which denied the blame. Biden's trip to the Middle East was supposed to calm the region, even as he demonstrated U.S. support for its ally, Israel, which has vowed to annihilate the Hamas movement whose fighters killed 1,400 Israelis in a rampage on October 7. The social media site X, formerly known as Twitter, has started charging new users in New Zealand and the Philippines for basic features such as posting messages in a trial aimed at reducing spam. Tech billionaire Elon Musk, who bought Twitter last year for $44 billion, has long complained about fake accounts, bots, and spam on the platform, introducing a number of controversial changes that have been sharply criticized by users around the world. Under the trial, named Not a Bot, new users in New Zealand and the Philippines will have to pay an annual fee for the ability to write on X, like and reply to posts, and bookmark content. It added that existing users will not be affected by the model, which will cost around $0.75 per year for new users in the Philippines and $0.85 for those in New Zealand. Those who decline to pay will be able to access X in a read-only mode, limited to viewing content and following accounts, the company said. 15 years after Malayali journalist Soumya Vishwanathan was shot dead in Delhi, the Sagar Sessions Court on Wednesday found all five accused guilty in the case. Additional Sessions Judge Ravindra Kumar Pandey convicted Ravi Kapoor, Amit Shukla, Baljeet Malik and Ajay Kumar under provisions of the Maharashtra Control of Organized Crime Act. Fifth accused Ajay Sethi was convicted under IPC Section 4114, dishonestly receiving stolen property, and under MCOCA provisions for conspiring to abet, aid or knowingly facilitate organized crime and for receiving the proceeds of organized crime. The judge said the prosecution proved beyond reasonable doubt the charges against the accused and listed the matter for sentencing on October 26. The woman journalist was shot dead on September 30, 2008 while she was returning home from work in her car around 3:30 a.m. Police had claimed that the motive behind the killing was robbery. Congress leader Rahul Gandhi on Wednesday cited a media report to accuse the Adani group of fleecing people to the tune of Rs 12,000 crores by making them pay more for electricity rates through over-invoicing of calling boards, and asked Prime Minister Narendra Modi to order a probe and come clean on the issue. Addressing a press conference at the AICC headquarters, Gandhi said the Congress, if voted to power, would order an investigation into the matter in 2024 and attacked Modi for his silence and questioned why he was not initiating a probe into the matter to defend his credibility. The former Congress chief displayed a recent Financial Times report at the press conference which claimed that the Adani Group appears to have imported billions of dollars of coal at prices well above market value. Gandhi claimed that, as per the report, Adani over-invoiced coal imports and took out Rs. 12,000 crore from people's pockets. Adani bought coal in Indonesia and when it reached India, its price doubled, Gandhi alleged, citing the report. Gandhi claimed this over-invoicing of coal was having an impact on electricity rates in the country and leading to consumers paying higher electricity bills, with some Congress-ruled states having to pay subsidies to the poor. The opposition party has also been questioning the financial dealings of billionaire Gautam Adani's group after US research firm Hindenburg alleged irregularities and charged it with stock price manipulation. The Adani group has denied all the allegations made in the Hindenburg report and claimed there had been no wrongdoing on its part. Information and Broadcasting Minister Anurag Thakur said that the Indian government on Wednesday hiked the inflation-adjusted allowance for its 11.7 million employees and pensioners by 4% ahead of the festival season. The move would cost the exchequer 128.57 billion rupees annually. The wage increase or dearness allowance, a part of monthly wages and pensions provided to cushion against rises in the cost of living, was effective beginning July 1, 2023, Thakur said on Wednesday. The federal and state governments generally announce twice-a-year adjustments in inflation-linked wages on top of an annual increment. The hike will benefit about 4.9 million government employees and 6.8 million pensioners, said a statement issued by the government. That brings us to the end of this episode. Thanks for listening to Daily News Dose, hosted by me, Renju Raj. Daily News Dose is produced by Vishnu Muralidharan with technical support from Idea Brew Studios. Follow on manorama.com for detailed updates on the latest news. And be sure to come back tomorrow.